first Dead Space felt like the spiritual successor to Res Evil 4 that Res Evil 5 failed to be. It didn't hamper the single-player experience with broken AI, it didn't give the enemies cover mechanics, and it didn't let you fucking grind all you want, effectively killing all strategy to weapons upgrades. Dead Space was all good monster fun, leaning on some established mechanics while foregoing traditional headshots for strategic dismemberment, which is
awesome.
Now, since this game is gory as all fuck, to make sure I don't upset some of you fuzzy bears, every time things get a little too intense, we'll take a brief intermission for cuddly Dago time. Okay? Had there been PlayStation Move support gameplay style a la RE4 Wii Edition, I would have gladly played it on PS3. And it just so happens that I do all my editing on an Apple monolith. So, for the purposes of this review, we're playing the PC version. Which means you're gonna have to forgive this pathetic quality off-screen recording. Dead Space 2 on the PC has gotta be one of the prettiest things I ever seen. This game should also, in particular, be commended for having one of the most epic intro sequences in recent gaming history. This game is very dark in the literal sense. Half of the time, all you can see is what your flashlight sees. Very Doom 3. Just like the last game, you've got your telekinesis, you got your stasis, both of which come into play when you're trying to conserve ammo, which is all the time. Yay, strategy. Dead Space 2 is clearly concerned with actual gameplay above story.
I'm Isaac.
Most of which will play out in transmissions, audio logs, etc., while you keep playing, aka not B-movie grade cutscene slogfests that make up 99% of all video game stories. Points. Not surprising, since the last game did the same. In fact, this game does have a little more story, but it's still so brief that it never drags the experience.
We're all gonna burn for what we did to you.
So, what's the story? Who cares? You're a guy in a suit and you shoot things. By things, I mean necromorphs, which are essentially big ol' mutant space zombies. And I love me some big ol' mutant space zombie. More than just coming in all kinds of shapes and sizes, their mode of attack varies just as much. In league with that, rather than guns just coming in all sizes, their use and effectiveness varies just as much. What that means is that this game is as much chess as it is Doom. Sure, on easier modes, you can gun your way through with more or less whatever you want. But on its harder modes, this game is all strategy. You'll enter a room and get prison raped a few times until you learn to plan things out. Speaking of which, Ed loved detonator gun long time. And AI's a sneaky little bitch. Soon as you think you got under control, let's see what's over me on. And die!
Kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it!
Clever girl.
There's something so rewarding about shooting children, especially if you're a parent. And I'm not a parent, but I consider this practice. Just something about using the corpse of a baby you just killed as an explosive projectile that warms my heart. Also, the addition of gravity thrusters instead of just leaping around in zero-G adds a whole new element to the game. Solid controls in zero-G 3D space ain't easy, and they nailed it. Now, since a lot of what you're seeing here is like shooting in corridors, you might think having your back to the wall makes you at least safe enough to just shoot at what's coming at you. But no, there's monster closets fucking everywhere. Walls, floor, ceiling, even if your back is against a wall, someone could just jump out that wall and grab you. You are never fucking safe. What was that? And that brings us to a little something I like to call Ode to Buzzsaw.
Thank you.
Now, there's something else here that the first game did not have, and that's multiplayer. Effectively, four humans are trying to complete a mission while four necromorphs are trying to stop them from completing a mission. You'll have four human players controlling each side, and then once the level's over, you switch, so you get to play as both the engineers and the necromorphs. When you're a necromorph, you get to choose what kind of necromorph you are. I've heard some people complain that when playing as a kid, landing jumps is near impossible. So either they patch that shit to make it easier, or I'm just that awesome. The thing about the multiplayer is it is tacked on, it is kind of in some respects a throwaway that people won't really pay attention to, that they kind of just added because now all games have to have a multiplayer. But you know what? I'm not going to complain about added value to my game unless it's like so bad it detracts. And frankly, I played the shit out of the multiplayer. I kind of ignored it at first, didn't think I'd give a shit, and then when I played it, got hooked and played the shit out. I love this fucking multiplayer. I ain't gonna lie, I love it. Shit, I don't care. This is my house. Alright, as we know, there's no such thing as perfection, so here's the downside. The first game had a really acute sense of isolation, mixed with an 80s sci-fi movie vibe, all of which here is gone. And even though the first game took place over less space on paper, I felt it had more variety. My favorite location is still the botany lab from the first game. Also, where the first game had like, I don't know, three big bosses amongst, you know, the mini bosses and big enemies, this game, as far as bosses go, there was really just one boss, and that was at the end. Eh, that was kind of my least favorite part of the game. I won't show you nothing or give anything away, but what I will say is that part of the reason that the, in other games, what would be called sluggish movement is permitted is because you're in a heavy engineering suit and the strategy about what ammo to use is really what comes into play. And it works in your favor because it's not built to be run and gun. Except for the final boss. The boss of this game requires run and gun. Well, that's not what the controls and movement are really based around, which makes the boss of the game, the only real boss fight in the game, sorta a mess. Also, PC DLC, get on that shit, bitches. You can't just have that shit for consoles, I tend to think most pre-game disclaimers are anywhere from dumb to silly, but this is really the first time when the lack of a seizure warning almost offends me. I'm not epileptic, but I can imagine anyone who was ending up with a wet floor. Not that it really matters, but the first Dead Space was accompanied by the release of a DVD animated movie called Dead Space Downfall, which was kind of cool. This time around, Dead Space 2 has been accompanied by the release of Dead Space Aftermath, which is a steaming pile of shit. In all of its 70 minutes, it has maybe 1 or 2 minutes total of space zombie. And almost half of the thing is rendered in what looks like Poser 2. Utterly pathetic. But who cares? This game is game-tastic, and we bask in its gory gameness.
If you ran for president, could you beat Barack Obama?
I believe so.
Alright, getting to be about that time. Sigourney Weaver Award. Cause, well, duh.